Okay, so where did I leave off? I left off with this kind of in a state now. One thing I should think about for resource uploading is the fact that it may not necessarily be fully synchronized. So I'm going to require mutex. That. Okay, we have that resource uploading. We can generate this on the fly. Now I want to actually go ahead and image. Going back to where's the error color image? Yes. Okay, let's actually get out of this and go to this. We have, all right. Generating it, providing it back. Loader. We got this. Okay. Levels. Okay, equals a standard power of 2U times MIP levels minus 1. Include CMath. Gonna have some things. I'm going to require what? I'm going to require like a staging buffer, I'll bet. Because it's an image, I can't just transfer. I still need, like, I can't just put it in the final memory like I could with model information, because it still may need to be like massaged or transformed however the implementation wants it. Tiling to be so that the image can be tiled properly or whatever, whatever the case may be. So I'm going to require, buffer and an allocation to go with it. Buffer. We'll need the final image. But we also need vector of VK copy buffer copy. Is there like an image copy type? Because each map level is going to need to be copied over separately. I need a vector type. Then we basically need these. So VMA allocation. Okay. So first of all, we need to image create the image. Create image create info. I need to know the exact layout of this thing. So image type. Type 2D, it's a 2D image. I'm not going to even touch 3D. Equals, was it? Format that's provided. No, it's extent. Extent 2D. Or is it a 3D type? 3D. Max extent, and it's one dimensional. MIP levels is num MIP levels. Array layers equals one. Bit sample on this. I'll do optimal. Sharing mode will be I guess it could be concurrent because it'd just be used for everyone. I don't know, it's just exclusive for the moment. Okay, I'm not even going to touch queue families. I'm missing usage. Okay, I won't even touch that yet either. Usage equals VK image usage. Transfer destination because we want to transfer it from outside. It's a sample type. Okay, we'll have VMA allocation, create info. A. GPU only. Done on that. VMA create image. There you are. So P resource loader. Do I have it even here? Yes, I do. Should be included, right? Yeah. C allocator. The image. Do we want to have the information back? I don't think so. No. If we failed, we'll have a little thing at the end. Create failed. Some whatever, and then we'll return res no matter what. We'll have to destroy the image if sampler not equal vk equals, yeah, not equals vk, no. Sampler. It's just a similar thing for if view image. Yeah, it's just view. Same thing at the end here. Come on. Nope, you lost it. Dang it. Had it a second ago. Okay, just reboot it. Da-ba-bam. You're gonna get everything right. Okay, image. Lock. Else, so if it did pass, do we want to give the information? Do we want to do, okay, because this is like the during the spin up of the engine, like creating an error color image, I'm not too concerned of doing it asynchronously. This can probably be done synchronously. Yeah, so if it failed, otherwise if it passed, then like we set the information, so P image. swap it around for the more likely case to be nestled in right there than the less likely case to be down here. So then you'll just go into here and then jump out. So we can even say, like, unlikely. Or something like that. Maybe? Not sure. We could say likely on this one. Whatever. It's advanced stuff beyond me right now. I was still doing this. So I created the image. I could go on and create the image view in the sampler. Or I could start the upload process during that. So I have the image. Let's actually start with the staging buffer, actually. Pixel count. I need the pixel count. And... is depth format. Okay, I need some newer functions here. Is it really part of format? Bytes per pixel. Okay, let's just kind of put it here for the moment. Device size. Should we use pixel count? In the mipmap level. No. It's the number of MIP levels, actually. Yes. As we go down into each one. Okay, so. Actually. Pixel count will equal. Depth. Then 4. No, we already have the first one, so we just need to start from 1 and go down. Or up. To calculate this as well for each MIP level, extent times the MIP map level. Okay. So we'll need to be able to VK extend 3D. The divisor. It should be like 1 to the power of level? Or shifted left? Type, which will be max of 1 u, because it has to be at least 1, it can't be 0. Do I need to static cast it? Float to, you know what, actually, no. Floor. Let's double check what mipmap sizes are in this mipmap. No mipmap. There must be a explanation of let's start at the top and go down. Oh, whoa. Here we go. It's the max between 1 and the width divided by 2 prime. And it's the same thing across all of them. So it'd be the floor of width. Okay. Width divided by the divisor. Now, problem with it. 2 are expected max. Parameter, there's 2 parameters. Okay. Unsigned int versus double. So this is a double. Wait, what? Why is... What? You're converting yourself to a double? Okay. Okay. Okay, one to the power of U to the side. Would it be? Zero, one, two. Yeah, okay, so no, that should work. Because then it'll return one. That divided by that is one. Yeah, okay. It'll return itself. I can work with that. Anyways, yeah. Where was I? Going back. Total data size. Going to pixel count, so of the extent times levels. Oh, yeah. And then we want to times it by the bytes per pixel. Just the format. In the aspect. Aspect color bit. Because we'd also have values for, let's say, depth and, because I also wanted like a checkerboard for depth and stencil, which are different sizes, I guess. The way to put it. And in this case, I want specifically color. And I'll reuse like the bytes per pixel and have like flag changing on them, which means I need to go to format here and do like a. What would it be? Like a VK device size type? Yeah, it would have to be. Oh. Image aspect, whoop. Like that. So no accept. We'll have to change it to format.cpp. This is not, I don't. Think no, it's something you can't really const express. Well, you could const expression, but I don't think it'll be very useful in that manner. So grab this, put it in like this. I mean, could actually really easily be a const expression type. Actually, if it's a switch statement, it'll be cheap. You know what? For the moment, I will actually have it as a const expression type. I'll convert it later if I have to. Our bytes per pixel equals 0. It starts off at 0. Then we got to go through if. Color equals that. Switch in here. Format. What are the ones I'm thinking of right now? Okay, format. R8GA. B8RGBA8SNorm. G8B8BGR8A8UNorm. These are BPP plus equals 4. There's 4 bytes per pixel for these guys. They kind of do the same thing, but for the slightly, the ones without alpha. And then, actually, break. Do-do-do, and then we'll just have a single case for, R8UNorm. Okay. Do this for the moment. What was the C standard lib? If it's a different, we'll abort right now, and I'll have to come back and actually add it in when I want to start using it. So kind of want to do the same thing for depth. So these are all the depth formats we have. So actually the default would otherwise be, actually no, because, actually yeah, if you're in here on a non-depth format, then what are you doing exactly? You should be alerted to that. Yeah. Okay. So what we have? We have depth. Okay. Move this one out. These are different. And then we got these two. So 10, 24, 32, 4, tree. Two. We do the same thing for stencil types. Except there's only the two types, I think. Three types. For the mole, it's always one byte. We return that. We want to include that. We're in here. We've got the bytes per pixel for specifically image color aspect right now. So that we have the total data size of the staging buffer anyways, because the information for the size, no, because the allocation for the image is already done by the VMA. So that's already handled. I just need the VK buffer info. The grid info. Total data size. Data byte size. Sounds a bit better. Transfer source. Exclusive sharing mode. CPU only, CPU copy. But, CPU copy or CPU usage. Actually, is there even, there's... Can actually, is there like an explanation of what it is? Okay. Lazily allocated. I don't think so. Oh wait, I'm looking at it the wrong way. It's the thing beforehand. That's why I'm reading all this wrong. Okay. Staging copy of resources used for transfer source. CPU only. Thank you. I kept reading the ones after as the explanation for them. Buffer. to do the same thing for these two, actually. We'll keep them separate. Hold on. We'll need to delete them either way, won't we? So yeah, if staging buffer, we're deleting him whether or not we actually succeeded. Because by this point, he would have already been uploaded and done with using him. Okay, so we recreated the staging area. So we'd have, what? Image view. Not staging, sampler. Okay, I don't know why. Okay. Once we have this, and then we have this, then, and these are successful, then we'll try to map data in. Then, if while this data is being copied into the GPU, we'll do these guys. Then we'll wait for it to complete. Then we'll come through to the output area. My 328T. Map number of areas, map memory for the allocator P resource. Mm-hmm. Okay. Okay. I'm reusing this over and over and over. This one, you close it up. So put him in there, and then we're going to want to put him down here. Times mip level of I. Then we're going to want to fill to error image data with the format we provided, the extent, which is. Which I've just calculated here. Num checker. Num check squares. Pass p data in. plus the offset, which starts with 0. The offset will be increased by size by byte per pixel format, and you can image aspect color bit that. Okay, what am I missing out of this? Don't check square p data. Okay, what's wrong? Map extent. Oh, it is like literally, yes. Depth. Okay. Mm-hmm. Okay. I equals VK buffer image copy. Okay. Buffer offset equals the offset we have right now. Sub resource equals row length and image height. I don't remember ever using them before, so I'm doubtful I need them really. But I instead, yeah. That. The offset is zeroed. The extent is extent. That's that. We row, go through all of them, then we leave. We map the data in, then we want to call the upload commands so that we can actually put it on the graphics card or the graphics memory or optimal, or yeah, into the optimal tile format. I'm going to need some kind of upload structure. That'll be kind of like common. So what do we need? What do we need? I have this source command buffer, the pool it's from, and a fence probably between them. And the semaphore for synchronization between the two. Like, basically like this. command buffer, command pool it came from. That way we can also return it. And a fence for when the source command buffer is completed. Let's roll with this, at least. Let's change the track. Some Fallout Vegas. Fallout, there we go. Radio New Vegas. Do I not have the OST? No, there it is. Okay. This is something I can actually probably reuse as well. Okay, let's see if we can actually like create first of all. Create an upload data struct, which takes which uses a would we? Both source and destination queue. Is there any reason we wouldn't want it? Okay. Be a bit too tired for this one. Okay, hold on. Maybe if I go through a little bit of the implementation first, it'll come to me. So let's say we already have the stuff. We begin recording. Let's say I already have the source or destination command pools. So So we go bk command for begin info. S type equals. Usage one time submit. Exactly sure what's going on with this, but there you go. If upload data, okay, we need one of these at least. If upload data dots source command buffer. Or equals VK null handle, meaning it's a graphics card with different transfer and graphics cues. Then we want to begin it. The command, no. Is there anything I actually need? Maybe not. No. It fails, go to create failed. We'll actually introduce a new one. Recording failed. Why on earth are these so crazy? Why can you not comprehend how this? Whatever. Otherwise, the destination is always going to be used. It's just the source that's optional. Like, I'm not, like, crazy or anything. I can't compile, almost. Allocator, the allocation, and then the data. Ooh, maybe this has to be, like, can't from unsigned charge ** is not allowed. Really? Okay, reinterpret. Simple enough. Okay, this is all. Yeah, I'm missing. Where do you go? You go to that. So I just have an extra one. Whatever. So we've recorded. We've begun the recording. We leave. Wait, what the hell is... Okay. Let's move this out. Let's move this out to something else. Okay. Sure. Just leave it at that for the moment. Then we'll have if pull that back out. We'll want to return and upload data from this. On success, that is. Else we'd have to delete and destroy this stuff. I don't even have the creation of this stuff yet. So create and destroy. Come back to this, it's going to definitely like fail at the moment. Actually, no, don't do it there, you idiot. Do it here. Okay. We also want to bookend this with an ending of the recording, of course. If this exists, then we want to end it. Okay, I got too many frickin' braces around here. I don't need them. Slightly less lines. Actually, no. Leave the braces. Here I go, just kind of going back and forth. What should I do? Nobody knows. Where will I end up? Okay. Then between them, of course, we gotta do the meat of the operations. So we got begun. We need to if p copy region. We need the copy regions with us. Was where are you you the p copy of regions also means we can actually have more than one image in this at once if we like batch the whole bunch together and then just Oh, yeah. That's an interesting thought. Yes, sirree. Like, especially if it's being loaded in from, like, a single file. A single file has multiple images or something. Like, a video? Or, like, animated GIF, maybe? I don't know. But what I do know is I need this. So what do I need? I first of all need to need image memory barriers. So I can prepare the. I need to prepare the destination for writing. And this needs to be on the same for each copy region as well, because it's the image, but it's a sub resource that's different. I must actually. Right now, I'm assuming that they're all from the same singular image. Okay. That. Transfer right. We're taking it from whatever it was to transfer. Undefined. Destination. Need to ignore it. I need to pass in the image, don't I? Yeah, I'm gonna need it. I'm also going to need. And I need like a this. So I think this requires. Scuppy regions don't actually know. Wait, maybe they do. Do they know what they are doing? Each VK buffer image. He's on. Sorry, not you. The copy data. VK image sub resource layers, but not the range. Do them one at a time. Sub resource. Okay, he's got what? What's he called? He's got the aspect mask. He's got the MIP level. He's got the base array. So basically, he's the same thing except layer. Wait, VK image sub resource layers is almost effectively the same as that? Hold on. What is the difference? Base MIP level is not the same. Okay. Okay, I can actually make this work for. I can make this work for. So what I was about to do was I was going to do an image memory barrier for the entirety of the image, and the whole sub-resource range. But I can actually just do it for individual mipmap levels. I guess it's not batched, but it gives me more flexibility to reuse this. For multiple images at once instead, which I think I can probably work with a bit more in the future than even if I'm not really quite using it right now. So we'll leave this actually as it is for the moment. Save that up. We exit out of that. So. To batch or not to batch? Damn it. I could just. Okay. What is simpler? Simpler is to assume that I'm passing in. That. For one image, I'm just putting in one image at a time per command buffer. That's it. Keep it simple. That. Keeping it bloody simple. Okay, auto command buffer equals if we have that. Okay. If that's true, then we're gonna pass back upload data dot source command buffer. Otherwise the destination one. really know what this means quite yet. I'm assuming zero, dependency flags is none, memory barrier count is none. Nope. Nope. There's one. One image memory barrier. Okay. And we copy them. Source buffer is passed in. Oh, I accidentally mirrored the same layout. I've already changed it to transfer destination. With the region being copy regions size being that the regions provided. Okay. So we've copied. We need to do change the destination to be shared or read only optimal. And this is the stage which we would actually if we were on different queues, we'd transfer who has exclusive use of the image. Of the Q family from the transfer to the graphics queue. So this should actually be separate scoped, yeah. If it's not all handled, then we actually want the whatever it was, P resource loader. I don't even provide the actual queue index, do I? I only provide actual Q family. Does this guy actually have the index? Yes, he does. Okay. Otherwise, it's ignored. So that means we only have the destination. Same thing on the destination side. Now, depending on whether or not we uploaded it or not. No, because the old layout will always be, yeah. Is there ever a case of pre-initialized? Actually, no, that's true. If we're dealing with some kind of weird pre-initialized memory, then we don't want to actually do the transfer. We just want to. Okay. Because then we'd have copy regions be null pointer, wouldn't we? But I don't actually have any of those cases right now, so don't. Don't! Trying to get ahead of myself. Memory barrier. Yeah, basically this stuff again. Except I'm gonna change a few items. So this is now here. He becomes. I need to actually provide these, don't I? Access flags. That you also need the final image layout. We'd also probably want to move this to be like first. Then the buffer, then the destination stuff, and then the return data. And then the cost and the key data. Okay, yeah. What was I? That we have he's transferred to this. Destination image layout. He's a source queue family. He's the destination queue family. Destination image, resource range. Okay. And we want to run if source command buffer not equals VK null. Put him on here. As part of the transfer process, you have to run the same. This barrier on both of them to transfer between one queue family and the other one. Okay, this is basically the same thing as this. Do 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 do, bam. Magic. Let me do the same thing for the destination. Then we go to the end recording, and then we'd return the fully recorded this. Now I need to actually be able to create this using the given this. Then I'll also need to be able to destroy. Data. I need to synchronize the command pools, though. I really do. Because they have to be externally synchronized. Oh man. An hour and a half to get to just this. Okay. What do we got? Dot source command equals p resource. Oh, sorry, not dot. Would it be not equal? Yeah, not equals VK command or VK null. This can actually be shared between both of them. That can also be shared. The command buffer level will be primary. And the number, command buffer count equals 1. So just that changes, just the command pool I'm getting it from, then we'd run VK as equals VK. Command buffers from the device. This should really be external. Again, like normal, it should really be external. The other things would be null by default. result. Otherwise, we go to create failed. Why is that wrong? Undeclared. Oh. Can't spell. Whoops, diddly doodly. Otherwise, we need to destroy upload data. Which would be like VK the device. And the data. Or rather, just upload. Okay, for the moment, upload data dot destroy. Otherwise, it's passed out. Okay. Destination, holy crap, destination. Actually, that's true. I can just start it off with destination command pool and just do that right off the bat. Destination, blah, 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 blah. Then we go into source, and then we can go into if we need them. We need, okay, hold on. Source command. Before, okay, we'd need we need at least the fence. We need to fence create info. It would have to be unsignaled as well. It's only for signaled. So we'll just leave it like that. And we'll just res equals VK create fence. You only what, create one at a time? Yeah. Fence. It's success, not the other one. I see. I need the fence CI up here as well. Also need the same thing on the source. If we have a source requirement, source queue requirement, I should say. And then if we have a source, that also means we need a semaphore between the two. Copy complete semaphore. Synchronize in between them. We need to put this in a sub thing so that we can actually info. Simfo create info dot pk semaphore. Are there any flags? I don't think there's any flags. Let's just be sure. Are there any flags? No, there are no flags. There's a fence. Yeah, it's the signal bit and the whatever. Yeah, it's just the signal bit. Guess we're clear on that one. Same thing. If red is not equal to that, just leave. Well, it's almost effectively the same thing at this point. Created it. Now we need to destroy it all. All we need is the device. So we can just go along with, go from the opposite order, I guess. Free command buffer device. Command pool. One and one command buffer. Dest fancy. And basically the copy these two for the source. Destroyed. We'll discard this. Don't really care about moving the stuff. Let's free it up. Well, we could just leave it there for now. We just need to destroy with the P that and the device. Let's actually move this into a separate thing while we're here. As we slowly explode the number of files. Slowly but surely. That need to grab this stuff. do that. Need to add upload. Upload is last. Okay. Oh, didn't click save the file. Okay. Yes. This doesn't matter. Failed, just leave. Cannot be assigned because it's copy. Standard mutex. Again, I know. Okay. No, this is a terrible idea. Okay, for the moment, we'll actually just kind of do this. So what we should really be doing is have the synchronization integrated into the pool when we need it. Okay, that all builds. So what did I even do? I got the upload data. I've recorded this stuff. So actually I should probably actually put it in here. I have the upload data. Which means I should actually put it down here. Oh, but the upload data should be empty. Oh, yes. It should be empty in case I need to destroy it. It is part of the creation. Yeah, if I leave like halfway through, I don't want bunk data. Oh, no. It's already mostly empty anyways. It's already zeroed out. So this is fine. Losing track of things. Upload data. This should be that. Empty it out, create, otherwise return. Oh, I have. No, because if this fails, then I just can return. Just like that. No problems. No problem whatsoever. Because I've created nothing. He cleans himself out and none of this has been created. We just leave nice and early. Okay. So I need to go down to. Okay, I mapped the data in. This is recording again. I've mapped the data in. Then I need to. Whole function's point was to record, upload. This is image sub resource range. It's color starts at 0. Level count. That's 1. Yeah, empty this up like that. What are the access flags? Access shader read. That's the final thing, and the final layout is. Shader read only optimal. Yes. And upload data. Typical thing, if it fails, get out of here. That actually means upload data if. Do I actually create the upload data? No, he'll be brought about by this. So at this point, yeah, if. He's empty. Okay, yeah. Okay, I've recorded. Now I want to submit. To submission just involves if I can think through the fog of my mind now. Okay, let's get a bit of a punchier track. That's okay. No. Yeah, okay, I can work with this. So uploading. Submission of uploading commands. Because I'm very, very, very rarely going to be doing this in batch. Time being. I need to start with the source command buffer, the source. If we have one. One, we got that. And if we do have a source, that means we do have a signal signal. Semaphores. That need to grab the queue. How do we get queues from this? How did I even do this? Okay, I can't think this. I'm going to come back to this in a little while once I recharge some coffee or something.